In this session, we will discuss few questions in communication engineering. These questions are taken from television engineering and antenna fundamentals. First question, this question is asked in Kerala BSc 2014. Primary colors used in color television are, see, primary colors used in color television are red, green and blue. All other colors are derived from these three primary colors. So correct option is red, green and blue. These are primary colors used in color television. Next question. The deflection of electron beam in a picture tube is achieved by option A, electromechanical means, option B, electrostatic means, option C, electromagnetic means, option D, none of the above. Here, the deflection of electron beam in a picture tube is achieved by electromagnetic means. So correct option is option C. This question is asked for Kerala BSc 2014. The color system used in India for television transmission. Options are C-CAM, B MEC-CAM, C NTSC, D PAL. The correct option is PAL system, phase alteration in line. This is the standard used in India. So the other standards are C-CAM and NTSC. C-CAM is used in France, China and Pakistan. Some European countries also use this standard C-CAM. It is developed by France in 1967. And NTSC is National Television System Committee, is a standard for America. It is used most of the countries in North America. PAL, that is phase alteration in line, is developed by Germany and used in India. Next question is, field frequency in PAL color system is. The field frequency in PAL color system is 50 Hz. The first developed storage type of camera is iconoscope, which was then replaced by image orthicon because of its high light sensitivity, stability and high quality of picture capabilities. So first developed storage type of camera tube is iconoscope. The correct option is option C. Here in this question, heater voltage of a picture tube is, it is 6.3. The heater voltage is 6.3 volt. Now in this question, the color subcarrier frequency in NTSC system is, color subcarrier frequency in NTSC system is 3.58 megahertz. You only remember this value, and correct frequency is this option A, 3.579545 megahertz. And for PAL system, this is for NTSC system, for PAL system, it is 4.43 megahertz. Correct value is 4.43361875 megahertz for PAL, phase alteration in line. Next question is, hue indicates in television engineering, hue means tint. It represents the predominant spectral color of the received light. The color of any object is distinguished by hue or its tint. So the correct option is C, dominant wavelength or frequency of a color. Next question, video bandwidth in PALM color television system. The video bandwidth of PALM color television system is 4.2 megahertz. Other standards are for this system are frame rate. Frame rate is 60 frames per second. Another is scanning rate, 525 lines, and color subcarrier frequency. Color subcarrier frequency is 3.575 megahertz. Video bandwidth. Video bandwidth is 4.2 megahertz. And sound carrier. Sound carrier frequency is 4.5 megahertz. Video bandwidth is 4.2 megahertz. So correct option is option D, 4.2 megahertz. In this question, the purpose of shadow masking in color picture tube. In color picture tube, electron beams are passed through a metallic plate with holes in it. Then it is coming to the rust. The purpose of shadow mask in color picture tube is to ensure that electron beam hits only the correctly colored phosphor dot. So there will be phosphor dots, red phosphor dots will be red, blue and green. So this mask is used to ensure that electron beam hits only the correctly colored phosphor dot and does not illuminate more than one dot. So the correct option is to ensure electron beam hits only correctly colored phosphorus dot and does not illuminate more than one dot. Next question. In television transmission India, the modulation schemes used. So you should understand the modulation for video information and sound information in PAL system. The system is used in India. The picture information is amplitude modulated and sound information is frequency modulated. So correct option is option 1, that is amplitude modulation for picture and frequency modulation for sound. So we'll use AM for picture and FM, frequency modulation for sound. The correct option is option 1. Now in this question, this is Kerala PSC question asked in 2009. In the US NTSC system, the sound carrier frequency is? The sound carrier frequency is 4.5 megahertz above picture carrier. So this is correct option. The spectrum of NTSC signal in NTSC system. Now this part is AM modulated picture information, picture, and this is sound signal part. Spectrum of sound signal part. The frequency, carrier frequency of sound signal is 4.5 megahertz above the carrier frequency, picture carrier frequency. So correct option is option A. Next question. TV receiving antenna is usually, the options are horn antenna, Yagi Uda antenna, rhombic antenna and lens antenna. And we know that Yagi Uda antenna is the widely used TV antenna. And it contains a driven element where we feed the signal or output is taken, and it is usually a folded dipole. A folded dipole. This is a driven element. This is feed driven element, and there will be some elements like this. So the other elements are called parasitic elements. So there will be one feed element and two or more parasitic elements. This parasitic element, whose length is more than that of driven element, is called reflector, and these elements are directors. Their function is to focus the beam in a particular direction. So this will give radiation pattern like this. So this is direction of maximum radiation. Direction of maximum radiation. So Yagi Uda antenna is the correct option. Next question. The beam width of an antenna is an indication of A, directivity, B, polarization, C, degree of concentration of radiation pattern, option D, bandwidth. Directivity means the focusing of a radiation pattern. If radiation pattern is like this, beam width, half power beam width will be like this. So as beam width decreases, the directivity increases. So directivity is closely related to the beam width. Correct option for this question is directivity. Beam width is taken between two half power points, and this is called half power beam width. It is usually expressed in angle theta. So beam width of an antenna is an indication of directivity. Next question. The picture transmission in TV is done by, so picture information is transmitted in TV by amplitude modulation. Next question. In a CRT, the deflection on the screen in meters per volt of deflection voltage. This is direct definition of deflection sensitivity. So deflection sensitivity, that is measured in meter per volt, is the deflection of the electron beam in screen in meters per volt of deflection voltage applied to the deflecting plates. Next question. In a CRO, the voltage that causes the deflection of electron beam from left to right side of CRT is called, correct option is time-based voltage. Voltage will be a linear function of time. Voltage will increase with the time. This voltage waveform is also called sweep voltage or time-based voltage. So it linearly increases with time. And this voltage is used in horizontal deflection plates so that electron beam moves from left to right side of CRT. This question is a definition of aspect ratio. Aspect ratio of a television screen is the ratio of width to height of a screen. So aspect ratio is defined as the ratio of width to height of a screen. In television, it is 4:3. In this question, one of the following is not a standardized system existing now for color TV. So NTSC is a standardized system. CCAM is a standardized system. PAL is a standardized system. But VHS stands for Video Home System. VHS is Video Home System. This stands for Consumer Level Analog Video Recording on Magnetic Tape Recorders. Next question. In visual display on CRT, the sweep voltage causes the spot to move about the screen horizontally from left to right at a constant velocity. This is the correct option. If we apply sweep voltage on horizontal deflecting plates, the spot electron beam moves from left to right at a constant velocity. Next question. The horizontal plates of a CRO are supplied with dash to observe the waveform of a signal. Answer is sawtooth waveform. Sawtooth waveform or time base. The sawtooth waveform is also called time base voltage or sweep voltage. And this is applied to observe the waveform signal.